Vaxa.
Hey, pleasant good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to University Credit Union Center here on the campus of UC Davis. It's another edition of NCAA basketball here on ESPN+. And today it's the visitors, Boise State, playing at UC Davis here in this non-conference matchup of two of the great mid-major teams in college basketball. Thanks again for joining us, everyone, alongside former Aggie great Kayla Livingston. I'm Greg Wong. And again, I appreciate everybody making us a part of your Thursday afternoon. UC Davis comes into this game 1-1, playing the Boise State Broncos 2-1, led by Gordy Presnell, who's in his 18th season at the helm of the Broncos. Two long-tenured head coaches matching up today. Jen Gross in her 12th season leading UC Davis. You can see that the Aggies have turned the lights off as they prepare for the player introductions. And while the Aggies get introduced onto the floor, that gives Kayla and I a chance to get you caught up on where these two teams stand. First of all, want to welcome Kayla to the broadcast team. We're very excited to have an Aggie legend joining us on the air throughout most of the games this season that we're airing here on ESPN Plus at UC Davis. So first of all, Kayla, welcome. It's a little weird being on this side of things as opposed to on the floor.
It is, but I'm kind of liking it over here. I don't have the pregame jitters as much, so I'm liking it on the sideline. I'm excited to be here with you.
Well, we're really excited to have Kayla with us. And she is one of the storylines this year because Kayla, you, along with Sierra Hall, Sage Stobart, no longer with the program, obviously. And so this UC Davis team is a very new group, led by a returnee, Evan Turner, who has been one of the great players in the history of this program. And now it's kind of her team, and this is an Aggie team that just lost on the road at Washington. They beat Bethel College, an NAIA school, to open up the season. Then they lost at UW over the weekend. Now they're playing another mid-major team, a good one from the Mountain West Conference in Boise State. What are you expecting from the matchup today?
I'm expecting Davis to be aggressive both on offense and defense. I think rebounding is going to be a big key for them coming off that Washington game. Boise has good players, tall players, so boxing out, rebounding is going to be a key for this game.
Yeah, UC Davis was out-rebounded 39-23 against Washington. Not necessarily unexpected. The Huskies have one of the tallest teams that the Aggies are going to play this year, although Boise, they post some pretty impressive post players, including some of the newcomers and the returnees. Abby Muse, who's a player from Brentwood, California, and Elodie Lalotte, who is another power forward on this team. So Jen Gross has her hands full game planning today. We're underway, UC Davis and Boise State, here on this Thursday matinee. Again, appreciate everybody making us a part of your Thursday afternoon. Here's a little leaning shot by Maya Hansen, who's one of the freshmen starting for Boise State. Came up with air, and the Aggies run it down. So UC Davis lost 82-60 on the road at Washington. That was a single-digit game at the half before the Huskies broke it open in the third quarter. Here's Harris, short on a three. And the rebound pulled down by Danny Bays for Boise State. Boise State, meanwhile, they're coming off a win against Weber State, 63-52. They won despite shooting just 1-for-17 from three-point land. This is a team perennially that shoots the ball well from three. Not last year, though. They were last in the conference from deep. We've got an offensive foul, and it's Sydney Burns taking the charge.
That's always good to see in the beginning of the game, getting on the floor, taking a charge from the big girls. So good to see Sydney out there.
So an excellent defensive start for the Aggies there as Burns takes the hit. He's trying to break the seal. Here's Megan Norris facing up. Gives for Turner. Turner on a high screen. Takes it to the rim, and she'll head to the line. And she'll be shooting two. And that's all.
That's a big second foul on number 33 last game.
Yeah, that's the second on Muse.
With her coming out early, that gives Davis some wiggle room to go under the basket, go post to post. So this should be good.
Yeah, Muse is probably their best player. Boise State came in averaging 16 and 11 in the first three games of the year. Again, she's from Brentwood. She's one of a couple of Bay Area products on this Broncos team. And one of their their returning starters, but she's going to have to take a seat and probably for a good chunk of the opening half. So Turner hits both of the free throws, and the Aggies jump on the board first. Here's Bays, the freshman from Brisbane. Turner to the deck, and they call a foul against her. I beg your pardon, they call the offensive foul. So it'll go the other way. It'll be Aggie ball. So UC Davis ball. Just under 2 minutes gone by, and the Broncos will apply a little pressure here. Sussman breaks it across. Burns whips a skip pass to Harris. Turner returns it to Burns, into Megan Norris, who goes up. Wave it off. It's an offensive foul.
Looks like there are going to be a couple offensive fouls this game. But I think that's important to note during the game. You got to see how the refs are calling it early so you can play the rest of the game how they want it so you can keep going up and down the court.
Yeah, you're just kind of taking inventory of the way
right. The
game's being officiated. Megan Norris now on defense, has to defend a very difficult post player. That is Elodie Lalotte, the junior who's from Paris, France, and she moved to the United States to play her high school ball. Turner backs up, shoots a three, knocks it down. Picking up right where she left off, 5 3-pointers in the game against UW. And the Aggies lead 5-2. Here's Hansen, the freshman floats it in. And a 5-4 lead for UC Davis. Evan Turner, 20 points that led all scorers in the game against Washington. She had 4 of those threes in the first half. And again, this is a big year for Evan. A lot of the onus being put on her to lead this team. Here's Sussman, nice little reverse pivot, and spins along the baseline to finish. Well, Lott will go to the line. For those who don't know, Kayla, formerly Kayla Conrad, the reason that...
Still legally
Kayla yeah. Conrad, but you married former Aggie football player Darius Livingston, and in that wedding were a couple of the players that are on the floor, including Evan Turner.
Yep, and Sydney Burns. She was also a bridesmaid, so giving them that bridesmaid energy.
But you're still impartial on the broadcast,
exactly.
Of course. Yeah.
Exactly.
Here comes Natalie Pasco, who's from Danville, and she is an outstanding freshman, number 32 in black, as Lalotte hits the first. Pasco, the freshman, pretty much won every award there is in Northern California when she played at San Ramon Valley High School. As you know, she has a lot of friends and family in attendance today, and she is off to a blazing beginning to her career.
In the Eastern Washington game, she had 23 points off the bench. And 23 points off the bench, that's impressive. So that's something Boise State really uses in their substitution.
Hansen throws it away. She scored 23 points on 7 made three-pointers. She went 7-for-8 from three-point land, which kind of gives you an indication of her skill set. Aggies turn it over against the press. So we've seen the Broncos vary their looks defensively and apply some of that pressure. Here in the opening 4 minutes, Hansen shoots a step back three and hits. She's the former Montana Gatorade High School Player of the Year. She won that award twice. Aggies with their first subgroup in and another turnover. That was an issue against the Huskies. The Aggies gave the ball away 19 times in that game. And already we're seeing the Broncos trying to force the issue with the press. trying to get around Jones was Beige. She couldn't hit, but an offensive rebound and a foul, and Trista Hull is going to the line. So we've seen the Broncos, Caleb, utilize three-quarter court pressure early on. What are some of the principles when you're trying to break down that type of pressure? And what are the Aggies trying to do offensively to bring the ball down the floor without turning it over?
Well, I think sometimes it's difficult when there's so much switch-up that's going on, but being able to take a couple dribbles back and analyze what's going on, but also push the ball. I mean, as you can see, it's already a pretty fast-paced game, but internally you need to make sure that you're slowing it down, making sure you're making the right pass and not trying to do too much.
Turner, that always helps. When you can knock down threes like Evan Turner, I mean, she is just on a tear to start the year. She is now 11 for 21 on threes to start the season. Here's Bays. Here's another great freshman on the team. She's, again, from Brisbane, and she kind of got bracketed there, and it went out of bounds. Last touch by the Aggies. So we're tied 10 all, just over 5 minutes gone by. Hansen, and the rebound by Campbell Gray. Here's Sable, extra pass, Baker, who only scored 1 point in the game last week against Washington. Nice pass, but Jones couldn't hit on the doorstep. Out of bounds, and they'll send it back to Boise State when we come back. 4:46 to go, first quarter. All even, 10 points each here on ESPN+. Well, Gordy Presnell in his 18th year for Boise State, trying to figure things out rotation-wise. A big storyline early, Abby Muse is on the bench. Probably Boise's best player, who's from Brentwood, but she picked up two early fouls, and we might not see her for the majority of this first half. Here it's three to shoot for the Aggies. Baker forced to hoist it up. Did she call glass, Kayla?
I think she did. We'll call glass.
All right, if you say so.
Her face didn't really show it, but I know internally she did.
Oh, it's one of those internal calling
exactly.
Up the glass. Got it.
And apparently I can read internal emotions.
Yeah, well, you're very talented. Here's a three, up and in. That is what Natalie Pasco does. Those 7 threes she hit against Eastern Washington, that was one shy of tying the Boise State record. And she's kind of a super sub off the bench this year. Turner on the back cut, nice setup by Jones, and the bounce with the left hand for Turner. Megan Jones, we're seeing her pretty much being the backup post this season for the Aggies with Linus Vanholm injured.
Yeah, that was a great read by Megan, making sure she got that pass there quick and high for Evan to go straight up with it.
We've got a foul here, and this is a hold called against UC Davis. Here's another look at what Kayla was just talking about. You've hit a few of those in your time,
you
Kayla.
You could call it the Kayla special, but maybe I'm the only one that does that.
No,
so.
I think I heard on some of the national broadcasts, they
were
saying
that's
the...
Yeah, actually it was ESPN Top 10.
Yeah, I heard that. Scott Van Pelt said it, yeah. Boise State ball. Here's Pasco, bounces it underneath. Lalotte able to finish. Sable was just called for that off-ball foul. And she's got the ball, number 14 in white. To the flaring Turner, who takes it baseline, goes up for a runner, got hit. No foul called, and Aggie bench a little perplexed. Broncos lead by one. As Kayla said earlier, it's a pretty high-paced game so far. Lalotte going right at Megan Jones, couldn't hit. Offensive rebound, though. That's off the mark from Trista Hull, and he'll stay right here with Boise State. So Lalotte's got 8 points so far. They're really force-feeding her the ball. The Broncos, just as a team, they will run their offense through their posts pretty often. And they saw all the points that Washington scored in the paint against UC Davis. Seems like a nice formula. Sydney McQuieter is checked in for the Broncos. Pasco knocked away by Turner. And here come the Aggies. It's Campbell Gray. That's what the Aggies are going to try to do a lot. And that's run down the floor. Turner takes it in. And she got hit to the floor. Bumped down. This foul called against Anna Osley. It'll be a sideline out of bounds for the Aggies. Fourth team foul, so it'll be free throws for the remaining 2.5 minutes of the quarter. Baker stops on a dime and finishes. She did not have a field goal attempt, Victoria Baker, against Washington. Just didn't have a lot of space to maneuver. Here's Pasco, nice little runner down the baseline. And we continue to go back and forth here in the opening quarter. Baker, one of the transfers for the Aggies. Sable takes a three and hits. Not sure. UC Davis. That's exactly the shot they envisioned going into that offensive possession, but all's well that ends well. Sable knocks it down. Boise State almost turns it over. Instead, it turned into a Pasco triple. And she's got eight. She hasn't missed. Here come the Aggies rushing it down. It's Turner again. Third three of the first quarter for Evan Turner. And it is a track meet here at University Credit Union Center. So Turner with 13 points here in the first on 4-for-5 shooting. Both teams are shooting the lights out. Here's a foul. Baker working around that screen. And that puts them over the limit, and it'll send the Broncos to the stripe. Well, we know the Aggies, they're going to try to run it down every chance they get. Here's a little three out of nothing for Tova Sable. And then Kayla, Evan Turner, off the push and transition. After that, able to get an open three.
She does it again. She does it again. That's all I can say. But, I mean, exchanging threes, that's always fun. But when it gets into a track meet, you got to make sure that you're making the extra pass, taking the right shot. You know, you get that energy. Both teams are making threes. You're both running up and down. But being able to stay calm is really important, too.
How does 8-for-10 for UC Davis in the first quarter sound? Boise State, I mean, they're 7-for-12. So we've seen a total of 7 missed shots on 22 attempts here in the first. Here's a near turnover again. The Broncos pressing, and Pasco tips it away with 1:05 to go. Kayla, are you seeing things flowing okay for UC Davis offensively? They're able to get out and transition, which always helps, but is the offense running pretty crisply so far?
I would say so. I think, like we were just talking, it's been pretty fast-paced, so I'm sure in the second quarter, Boise is going to make some adjustments, forcing Davis to run a little more set plays, so we'll see then.
Sable can't hit that three. And it turns into an open three on the right wing. That is off the mark by Osley, who's a good three-point shooter, though an offensive rebound. And it will stay with the Broncos. Boise State, they are out-rebounding the Aggies 7-2, but that's a little misleading because the Aggies have only missed 2 shots so far. Lavrovic gives for Osley, who is coming off the bench this year. She was a starter last season. She's from Scottsdale, Arizona. Pasco again. How hot is she? Not that time. And the long rebound chased down by Mozzie Harris, and the Aggies can hold it for the final shot of the quarter. Both teams with 4 turnovers. Aggies don't have any fast break points according to the stats, but I think that doesn't account for some of the semi-transition looks they've gotten. Sussman, nice job to secure that. Turner, step back three. Good if it goes. Got another. It's a 16-point first quarter by the Aggie star, Evan Turner. And she nails her fourth three-pointer with the timer winding down in the first. What an explosion by Evan Turner. Second quarter sets it again, and if the first quarter was any indication, it could be a historic afternoon for Evan Turner, who scored 16 points in the first 10 minutes of play, 5-for-6 shooting and 4-for-5 from three-point territory. Kayle, I know you've seen that both in the game and in practice many times, but she is some type of player.
I mean, that's big. 16 points in the first quarter. Just what she can do next is going to be great.
Oh. Now. That is, I think that's got to be her career high for a quarter. And it's UC Davis leading by three, and the last one she hit was right at the end of the shot clock at the end of the first quarter, and hit it right in the face of a Boise State defender. I mean, the look she's getting, I mean, she's had to create some of these off the dribble, too. It's not like they're just catch and shoot. Hansen works it back to Osley. Both teams were just in an offensive tear in the first quarter. Aggie shot 75%. That'll always help your cause. Boise State around 47%. Shot clock is down to 5. Lavrovic gives it to Pasco, who whips it back to Lavrovic. This will count. It's short. And it's tipped out. And it's last touch by UC Davis. So Boise State again able to keep the possession alive. And 16 points in a first quarter, that is the highest, not just for Turner, but it's got to be one of the highest totals that an Aggie has ever scored in a quarter at all, first or otherwise. Kayla, did you ever have 16 points in a quarter?
I was lucky if I had 16 points in a game, Greg. Don't do me like that. But good for Evan. Good for Evan.
They kept stats about all the dirty work you did.
Yeah. Had probably 16 charges, maybe.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what matters. Yeah.
Aggies turn it over. Bays stops for a pull-up. Rattles out. Offensive rebound, though, and the finish by Trista Hall. And that will not make Jen Gross and the rest of her coaching staff happy. Boise State has dominated the glass so far. They're out-rebounding the Aggies 8-4. Turner. That's 6 offensive rebounds, too. Turner stepped out of bounds. 6 offensive rebounds for Boise State on their 10 missed shots. Here's a big applause for Mary Kay Nero, who is onto the floor for the first time for Boise State. There's a turnover, intercepted by Mozzie Harris. Harris the other way, and banks it up and in. Now the Aggies get out in transition. Mozzie Harris, an excellent defender, able to get the bucket. Aggies now will switch into some Buzz defense, giving the Broncos a different look. It turns into a Hansen triple, and Harris had to go off her fingertips. Right there is Sydney Burns. And the Aggies looking to push quickly. Sussman all the way in, and she'll get herself to the line. Nice take by Tess Sussman. Here's a look at Mozzie Harris. I mean, this is the reason that she's in. It's for the way she can shoot and the way she can defend like that.
Yeah, and that's really good of her to keep going to the basket. Sometimes when you see a defender in front of you, you want to pull it back or try something fancy, but she just went up strong and it ended well.
Now going right at the defender, and Sussman is going to the line. The foul is called against Hull. It's her second. Again, Abby Muse is out for Boise State. with two fouls she picked up in the opening minutes of the game, their leading scorer. I was talking about Mary Kay Narrow in the game for Boise State. Her grandfather is the great Rick Adelman, who people in this area know very well. He was the last coach to lead the Kings to the playoffs back in the early 2000s. And that is her granddaughter, Mary Kay Narrow, who has a sister that's also on the team as well, Mackenzie. Narrow is number 12 in black. Here's a little back cut again. That was a tough angle for Mozzie Harris.
I don't think she was really expecting that one either.
We'll talk about that in a sec. First, it goes out of bounds. The Aggies force a turnover. Boise State has gotten a little sloppy here in the second. When you're in the high post reading that play, it's not an automatic pass, right? When a player's cutting backdoor, what is the read there?
I mean, first you got to look at the player's defender. If they're right on front of them, you don't want to throw that. But the second thing is the help defender, too. If they're over there, you definitely don't want to throw it. That one was just the defender was on her. It was a little high. And you have to make sure that you're on the same page. So, I mean, obviously that's a big thing. So, I mean, there's like three things you got to pay attention to, which is a lot because it's three things in about 0.2 seconds.
And that is definitely a storyline this year for the Aggies. As the Aggies fortunate to save the possession, Sussman can't hit. And this is a team that's still learning to play with each other because, I don't know if you know, Kayla, the Aggies lost a lot of talent from last year's team, some players that have been in the program a long time. And so this a team that's still working on their chemistry. Here's a little pick and roll pass. The finish and a foul for Elodie Lalotte, who's got 10 points so far for UC Davis. Jones called for the foul, and so Lalotte is going to the line.
Yeah, Boise's running a lot of screen offense, and that can be tough because you're switching on different players, different matchups, and your rotations have to be on point. So on that one, the rotation was a little slow, causing Megan Jones to get that foul.
They actually assessed this one to, yeah, they did. They corrected it. It was Sussman, but they give it to Jones, and the free throw is off the mark. Yeah, Boise, they screen a lot to get free on offense. 10 points for Lalotte. That leads Boise. Pasco with 8. Here is Sable. Her defender fell down. That opened up the shot. She couldn't finish with a left hand. A nice second half showing for Tova Sable that gave the Aggies a glimpse of what she can do against Washington. Lalotte on the quick entry, tried to hook it home and came up strong.
She's good in that paint, so you really got to push her out. You can't let her get that hook shot. So being able to keep her out is a big key for the Davis Post players.
Here's Tova Sable. They don't call the foul. That opens up the shot. Missed as Bays went to the deck. And they're going to call a jump ball here. And the arrow will give it back to Boise, who is shooting down to 43%. Both teams have cooled off since that blistering beginning. Boise is 2 for 7. Aggies are 1 for 5 here in the second quarter. So here's Mary Kay Narrow, who a couple years ago led the Mountain West in assist. Bays, little spin, and Jones with a block. And she is filling up the block stat early this season. She had 3 coming into this game, including a pair against UW. She's got her first of the game there. And that'll take us to the media break. Aggies holding on to a 3-point lead, just under 5 to go. Good ball game so far. Boise State and UC Davis, two teams that have really dominated the mid-major level the last few years. Pasco, the inbounder, gets free for a 3, missed it. Jones able to secure the rebound. Megan Norris, by the way, the Aggie post player and their starting center, she has been out with 2 fouls most of the first half, so both teams have lost their starting big for probably the remainder of the half. In fact, both of them have barely played in terms of Abby Muse for Boise State and Megan Norris for UC Davis. Tova Sable gets a layup. Understand our score bug is down, so we'll keep you updated on the time and score here. 31-26 UC Davis, 4:18 left here in the half. There's Megan Norris, who has been sitting there for majority of this first half.
Yeah, and I mean for both sides, for both of the posts, that's tough as a player. I mean, you get all warmed up, get ready to go, and then you got to sit right away. So seeing how they come out in the second half, how they handle that situation will be interesting. And I think for Megan Norris as a new player, it's something that she's got to learn to adjust to.
Yeah, she's only played 3 minutes. That was the first 3 minutes of the game. Meanwhile, Muse only played 1 minute before picking up two fouls. Again, the leading scorer for Boise State. The Aggies holding on to a 5-point lead, under 4 minutes to go, 31-26. Sanders playing in her first minutes of the afternoon, 20 in white. Here's Sydney Burns, nice take to the bucket. That's something that Sydney has become pretty skilled at, a player that can create her own shot.
Yeah, and I mean, she has that quick first step, so that's what gets her to the basket, and I think, hard hit right there.
Yeah,
but seeing her be able to dish out passes and score is always good for the point guard.
It's a held ball. Burns got hit on a tough screen by Lalotte, and the arrow will give it to UC Davis. And yeah, that's what we've seen, that first step for Sydney when she can get past her primary defender. She's been able to get some layups off of that move. Burns, who started all 26 games she appeared in last year as a true freshman. And those are her first points of the afternoon. The Aggies have opened up their biggest lead, 33-26, with just over 3 minutes to go in the half. Turner, who's sitting on 16 points, all of which she scored in the first quarter. Boomeranged over to Burns, and she was bumped by Lalotte. That's the first call against Lalotte. And so Sydney Burns going to the free throw line. How impressed were you with her last year? I mentioned she started every game last season. That was in a group with yourself and Sage Stobart, Sierra Hall, Evan Turner, players that have been around the program a while, and she's a fresh face having to be the point guard. How impressed were you by the way she handled those duties last season?
I mean, I could never do that, so that I was very impressed with her. I mean, there was a lot of ups and downs last season, but she was always super positive, always willing to work, willing to take coaching, and I mean, that's what's helping her become the player that she is today, so.
Aggies lead by 9 after Burns hits both of the free throws, and now they force another miss. So Boise State really starting to struggle on the offensive end. The Aggies are on a 6-0 run, and Boise is 0 for their last 5. And now Baker got fouled. And that's only the fourth team foul against the Broncos, so one more and the Aggies will be at the line. It's called against Hansen. It's her first. Burns, pull up again. And Sydney Burns has ripped off 6 points in quick succession, and the Aggies have opened up a double-digit lead. Boise State has only scored 4 points here in the second quarter. Osley trying to get around the buzz pressure. Here's Lalotte, back out to Osley. Hansen, a little jump stop. Can't float that one in. Offensive rebound again. It's Allie Heckman who lays it in. That breaks an 8-0 run. It's a 12-4 run overall for UC Davis. 6 second chance points for Boise State. So after they scored 22 in the first 10 minutes, they only have 6 here in the second. Baker, nice little spin, pump fake. Couldn't finish that. Got her own miss. Somehow finds Mozzie Harris, hits her right in the shooting pocket. Came up short on a 3, Burns trying to wrestle for the rebound. Baker takes it away. It's still loose. And the arrow will give it back to Boise, but that is kind of a typical Victoria Baker type play. She is always on the deck, always scrounging for loose balls. There's something about number 23 that kind of gets you into that mindset.
Yeah, I mean, the hustle player right there. I mean, unfortunately, they called a foul on her right there, but I mean, you saw Sydney and Victoria both on the ground, so those hustle plays are always good.
I thought they called a jump ball. Instead, it is a foul. That's the second on Baker. Lalotte gets a layup. Lalotte, who was a returning starter from last year. I mentioned she moved here from France when she was in high school, where she played at Orange Wood Academy, which is in Garden Grove, down south. Turner hasn't scored yet in the second quarter. In and out that time. And Baker again trying to scrounge for the loose ball. Cannot. Aggies lead by seven. See if they can close the half strong. Pretty entertaining first 20 minutes of play. Osley, a little screen and roll action. Here's Lalotte with the left hand, and she is giving the Aggies work so far here in the first 20 minutes. 14 points for Lalotte.
That's tough. She's able to cut to the basket, create for her teammates, create for herself. So during halftime, that's going to be a point of emphasis for them to work on.
Obviously, again, UC Davis has been without the services of their starting center, Megan Norris. So Megan Jones has had to play a lot here in the first half. Norris has two fouls. We've got an offensive foul. They called it against Evan Turner. It was away from the ball, and that's the look of a player that is not exactly in agreement, Evan. So the Aggies have to defend here for the final 4 seconds. Hansen with two, shovels it off. Osley trying to get it up, and the Broncos don't get it away. That will not count. And Boise State cannot get a shot to close the half, but they close what was an 11-point deficit down to five. Aggies lead 37-32. Halftime at University Credit Union Center. We'll talk to you in the second half. Gordy Presnell, the 18th year head coach for Boise State, one of the longest tenured coaches in the entire country, 15th longest tenured coach in women's college basketball. It's not often that Jen Gross is opposing a coach that's been at a program longer than her, but Gordy Presnell takes this one, although Jen has been with the program in total for 19 years, 12 as a head coach. The other seven were when she was an assistant under Sandy Simpson. Prior to that, she was also a player, a great player. She's a Cal Aggie Hall of Famer for her work on the floor in the division 2 days. Back here at halftime, it's UC Davis 37 and Boise State 32. Much of that due to the play of the great Evan Turner, who didn't score in the second quarter, but in the first, she put up 16 points, including 4 three-pointers. Just a terrific half overall for Evan, Taylor.
Yeah, and I think even though she didn't score any in the second quarter, the first quarter really brought a lot of energy to the team, especially when Evan's scoring, hitting her threes. So I'm sure Boise's going to make some adjustments. Davis is going to make their adjustments as well, but I think it should be another good scoring half. I think being able to have other girls contribute, Sydney, Victoria, Tess, Mozzie, having other girls being able to score is also good. So when Evan doesn't score in the second quarter, you're not losing any points.
Yeah, the Aggies still outscored Boise 12-10. In fact, at one point in that second quarter, the Aggies had an 11-point lead. Boise had a nice close to end the opening 20 minutes. Aggies outscored Boise 12-10 in that second quarter alone. They outscored them 25-22 in the first. And we saw the Aggies in the second quarter kind of vary their defensive looks. Jen Gross has talked about how she's going to change it up defensively, not like when you were playing where it was mainly man-to-man. We'd see a lot more zone, and there in the second quarter they got a little more aggressive, amped up the half-court pressure, and it seemed to have paid off a little bit.
Yeah, and I think the defense is going to change again as we have new personnel in the game. Norris is back, Muse is back, so you're going to see more defense from the Aggies once again.
Megan Norris played 3 minutes in the first half. Abby Muse played one. And Muse, again, is probably their best all-around scorer and rebounder, 16 and 11. And so she is back in there, 33 in black, and so is 25 in white. Megan Norris, who played nice defense there on the lot, who got all she could eat in the first half, 14 points. So an entertaining first 20 minutes. We'll see what the second half has in store. Norris post up, works on Lalotte, banks it up and in. Megan Norris only hit one shot in the game against UW. Again, prior to this year, she had not played competitive basketball since 2020. And even that year, she pretty much missed her entire senior year of high school because of an injury. Well, Locke goes right back at Norris and returns the favor.
The middle shot is her favorite shot, so you need to adjust what shoulder you're on, not allowing her to keep going to that middle. It'll make it more challenging for her to make shots and not let them go to her as much.
Harris misses a three. Saw a lot of Megan Jones in the first half because of the foul trouble for Norris. There's a turnover. Turner can't hit the three. Sussman on the glass, and she is heading to the free throw line. That is the first offensive rebound of the game for UC Davis. And another look at that nice post move that Megan Norris just had.
Strong move. She took her time. And like I said before, you know, sometimes when you are out that whole first half, it can be hard to come back in the second half. But being able to score a basket right off the start of it is good for her.
Yeah, what's that like as a player? I know you didn't like it when it happened, but sometimes there's not much you could do about it. You pick up two early fouls and a half, and then you know, right, as a player, you know you're probably going to be out for the rest of the half. How does that change things mentally for you, and how are you prepping for what you're going to do in the second half during the first half?
Yeah, it's really tough. It can be frustrating, and then when you come out to play, it can kind of be a little – you can be a little timid with it because you don't want to get that third one and come out, but also not letting it alter your game.
The coaches, they tell you continue playing the same style, or do you need to change things up a bit?
You know, play the same style, but be careful. So it's like, well, okay, so how I was playing, I was getting fouls, so how do you want me to do that? But, I mean, there's always a way, and Megan Norris is going to be able to do that in the rest of this game.
Just saw that held ball. That'll give it to UC Davis on the alternating arrow. Megan Norris off to a nice start to this second half. A lot of room for growth for Megan, a player that the Aggies are about as high on as I've seen here at UC Davis. Turner makes her move, got bumped down, no foul call, and this is just a straight turnover. Aggies are asking for a push. It was not given. Anita Ortega, Mark Merritt, and Kathleen Cassidy are our three officials today. Aggies have led by as much as 11. Here's Lalotte again. Doesn't get the touch that time. Norris played good defense. This is out. Last touch by Lalotte. It's a little different interior defense for UC Davis here in the second half with Norris in there to work against the lot, but Boise State, they have continued to just go right at the Aggies in the paint. Turner off, nice ball movement, can't hit the three, and that should be off of Abby Muse, and it is. Tova Sable, transfer from Penn State, checks in. Mozzie Harris to the bench for the Aggies.
Sydney fixing her hair right there.
That's a huge deal pregame, right? The way you're gonna wear your hair.
Yeah.
I know it is for me.
Well, I did receive a text this morning
yeah.
how I should wear my hair from number 13 over there, but I guess she didn't take my advice, so you know.
Wait, she did not follow whatever guidance you gave her. Sable, nice spin, couldn't hit.
Very rare on her part,
right.
But. Yeah, I mean, if she has a good game, then I guess that's that. But if not, then
right.
It was the hair.
We know exactly what happened. Norris, I think, got a fingertip on that. Mary Kay Narrow gets the rebound, though. Pasco with a left hand came up well short. And the Aggies galloping the other way. Turner sets up Sable. Transition three, you bet. And it's back to 10, the lead for the Aggies. Any chance the Aggies get to rush down the floor, they take. Here's Muse. That's a nice move to get around Tess Sussman. And that is the first points of the game for Muse, who averages 16 per game in the first few matchups of the year. Norris calls for the ball. Wants it in the high post. Turner, that is a busted coverage, but Turner couldn't hit, and again, she has not scored since the first quarter. Boise State with a mistake, but they don't pay for it. Ball fake, hands into the rim. Sussman got a hand on it. And yeah, he's playing some nice defense here. Burns down the floor, and Turner finishes with a left. And Gordy Presnell wants to stop the run. Aggies have opened up a 10-point lead, 46-36. UC Davis on top. Timeout called by Boise State. We'll take it too. Evan Turner igniting some transition opportunities for UC Davis along with her backcourt mate, Sydney Burns. Those are the two returning starters to UC Davis. First, Turner sets up the Sable three, and then Sydney Burns pushes the pace in transition.
Yeah, that's good by Evan. Just keep penetrating, looking for that open player. Sometimes you can pull it back out, but that the fact that she penetrated got that open shot, and here she is with her steal.
Turner to the rim, lays it up, doesn't get the bounce, and Nero will force her to earn it at the line. 18 points for Turner on 6-for-12 shooting, and Turner upset that she wasn't able to get the and one, but there's another turnover, and that is what the Aggies thrive on because it converts into scoring chances. That's 12 turnovers for Boise State. The Broncos forced 22 turnovers against Weber State in their win a game ago. Turner is an excellent free thrower. And the Aggies lead by a dozen. It's their biggest lead. This, by the way, this is Boise State's only true road game of preseason play. Pasco gets a good look. Misfires, rebounded by Muse. The only other quote-unquote road games are neutral court games, these preseason tournaments. Nero can't hit. He has not scored today. Contrasted with the Aggies, only have four games at home here in non-conference. Turner for three. Can't hit again. Norris trying to get it, and the held ball is called. Along with Abby Muse, a couple of Bay Area products getting a little tussle. The arrow will give it to Boise State. Turner not able to hit that three, and you've been in a few of those, Kayla.
And who do you think won those tussles, Greg?
Kayla Conrad.
Thank you.
I watched them all.
With my team behind my back, because, you know, if it got a little out of hand, you never know.
I see. You weren't ready to square up or anything like that, Kayla?
I didn't need to. I had the team behind my back.
That's true.
And I probably wouldn't, you know, I don't know.
Sable. Muse with the rebound. Aggies are outscoring the Broncos 11-4. Boise State, since that 22 points they put on the board in the first quarter, have been held in check on the offensive end. Here, Mary Kay Nero is going to the line after she was grabbed. She was their starting point guard the last few seasons. And a foul called against Turner, it's her second. We've hit the media timeout. Free throws coming. When we come back, Aggies have opened up their biggest lead of the afternoon. At the line is Mary Kay Nero, who I mentioned earlier, the granddaughter of the Naismith Hall of Famer, Rick Adelman, who coached the Kings from 1996 to 2002 and coached them to some of their great heights ever. 1999 to 2006, I beg your pardon. And again, that was the last time that the Kings made the playoffs. And that was one of a number of teams he coached in his long basketball career. Mary Kay, that is the name of Rick Adelman's wife. And that's given to his granddaughter here, Mary Kay Nero. Baker to the rim, misses. And now the Broncos trying to push it. It's a team that has the capability to score in bunches. A lot of different players that can put the ball in the hoop, including Mary Kay Nero, who got a good look that time, but some nice help. And here come the Aggies rushing it down the other end. A little Euro step, Baker to the floor, doesn't get the foul called. She's still scrapping for the ball. She's got it. And it's ripped free of her hands by Mary Kay Nero. I'm just getting exhausted watching Victoria Baker running up and down the floor. She'll get a break here. It's a foul. And that is called against Abby Muse. That's her third. She is picking up right where the last number 23 left off with how much she goes for loose balls. Something about the jersey transforms you, I think, Kayla.
It has magical powers. Uh-huh. I don't want to say I gave it magical powers, but I think so there's some residue over. You never know.
It's got the juju,
and
yeah.
She's on the floor, so there has to be something in there still.
You know a little bit something about
being
on the deck.
Yeah, a little too much. Yeah. A little too much, actually. My body's feeling great now, though.
Good.
Not on the floor.
When's the last time you picked up a ball?
Good question, Greg.
Yeah.
Back to the game.
Yeah. Boise State showing pressure. Turner gives to Norris on the pop, fires, can't hit the three. That is something that she can do. She has the ability to stretch the floor. Any defense has held them to just 6 points. Again, they varied their looks defensively. They're playing man here. Baker got beat back door. And that'll get the Broncos to the free throw line in the form of Natalie Pasco. I do enjoy watching Victoria Baker play. She's a fun player to watch. We saw her the last game against Bethel. I see the foul she commits there, but she had a saucy behind the back in transition. Good player that plays with a lot of flair. So Pasco's at the line. Kayla mentioned that she went for 23 points against Eastern Washington a couple games ago. 7 3-pointers in that game. For the year, she's 9 for 15 on threes. I mean, she was an absolute star at San Ramon Valley High School. She was also class president since she was a sophomore. So 3 years in a row, she was class president, and she was one of the best college or best girls basketball players in Northern California. So it's a lot more accomplished than I was in high school. Turner hits her first three since the first quarter. Aggies lead by 11. They've led by as much as 12. And Turner's got 23. Edging closer or at her career high. Sable to the floor. Offensive foul. Here's another look at the Turner three. She's had a few go in and out since that first quarter eruption. But that's a sound, that swish of the net that she knows pretty well. See the three-point disparity. Boise State coming off that miserable shooting day against Weber State. 1 for 17 on threes. Today, they're just 2 for 9. Harris can't get the roll. And Muse the rebound. Greg Wong joined by Kayla Livingston. UC Davis leads 51-40 with under 3 to play. And Campbell Gray got a piece of the arm of the offensive player for Boise State. That was Jada Clark, who took a hard stumble. Right next to Aggie soccer player Ethan Horde, who is one of a number of athletes that also works in athletics, helps out the athletic department. He is sitting down underneath the hoop. Jada Clark is up there. There's Ethan. You can see him just left of the basketball stanchion. I think he's had a nice soccer year. Very young soccer team, too. Lost in the Big West tournament. Clark hits both. 9-point game. Turner, that's a long diagonal, and it turns into a turnover. Clark. Boise State trying to make some headway on this Aggie lead to close the third quarter. Another foul, so this is the 14th foul against UC Davis. Against Mozzie Harris. Here's Muse. A little turnaround. Jones with a nice contest. And Jones with a rebound. Muse with only 2 points tonight. Gray, little spin. Gets rid of it, finds Megan Jones. And the rebound pulled down by Abby Muse. Muse again, she's from Brentwood, played at Heritage High School. That's the same high school that former Aggie star Ezra Magnon played at. He is now playing for Vanderbilt after transferring. Another turnover against the Broncos. All right, Kayla, we've got about 70 seconds left here in the third quarter. How would you kind of assess where things are at? They've kind of slowed down in the last few minutes.
Yeah, Boise State is coming out with more of an aggressive press.
Turner, that'll count. And so she draws a foul against that pressure. And she'll go to the line for a chance at an and one. Get another look. Gray with the setup. And the foul called against Osley. Go ahead and finish your point, Kayla.
I forgot my point. That was a good play.
That's good. Evan Turner, I mean, she just captures the attention.
Yeah.
Magical.
It took my breath away. It took my point away.
You're talking about Boise State, their aggressive defense.
Yes, and their press. I think that's just something. And the fouls. I feel like there's been a lot of fouls this second or the third quarter, as you can see another one right here. So slowing the game down a little bit. The first quarter and second quarter, there was a lot more fast pace. So I think the fouls and more aggressive defense is contributing to the slower pace game right now.
And right on cue, as Kayla said, there's a foul. It's called against Megan Jones, and this is on the floor, but Aggies are over the limit. And so Abby Muse is at the line. Yeah, the Broncos last year were just 8 wins. That was their worst year in about a decade, wins-wise. Normally, they are a team that competes year in and year out for the Mountain West Conference title. At one point, they had made it to the NCAA tournament for 4 straight years. And their last of those runs was the COVID year. They qualified for the NCAA tournament. They won the tournament, but obviously the tournament was never played because of COVID. Unlike Kayla, your team, you guys never made it to even the conference tournament, as Turner can't hit the three. And another foul, and this happens about 80 feet away from the other hoop, and it turns into a chance for Boise State to get more points.
Yeah, when you know they have free throws under the basket, when they have the rebound, that's not really a smart foul. But I get it. I mean, I was there. It's hard not to be aggressive, but just being mindful of that. Especially there's 24 seconds left. Don't want them to get any extra points at the end of the quarter.
Mozzie Harris has called for the foul. So that's a situation where maybe in another circumstance you'd be a little more aggressive trying to get the ball back, but maybe just live to see another day.
Yeah, typically you don't want to have those backcourt fouls. So just being mindful of that, like I said before.
Yeah, Boise State, they've shot 15 free throws today. In fact, the Aggies have shot 11, and after that make, both teams have combined only missed one free throw, which is a welcome sign for UC Davis especially, because they had a rough game from the line against UW. They went 7 for 18 from the stripe against Washington. You think if they made a few more of those, then they could have stayed in that game longer. But tonight they are 11 for 11 from the stripe. Here's Tova Sable, gets doubled backside, finds the open shooter. It's Megan Norris who fills the cup on a three. A half-court heave, this will count. And that'll take us to the end of the third. Megan Norris knocks down her first career three-pointer. Sable with the setup, Norris with the three, and the Yankees take an 11-point lead into the fourth. Gordy Presnell and the rest of his coaching staff watching with his team down 11 as we begin play here in the fourth quarter. 26 points for Evan Turner. That's a new career high, and here she sets up her teammate Tova Sable, and the lead is up to 13 for UC Davis. Osley gives it inside. Here's Lalotte, who was quiet in the third quarter, uses the left hand there, and she's up to 20 points.
She's really good when she gets over that middle shoulder. So I said this before, but Davis needs to just kind of harp on that in the timeouts and not let her get going as much as she is.
Sable got the seal, couldn't finish it. Still on the glass, but Muse comes over to help and gets a hand on the ball. And we'll see if they go to her again. They push it. Pasco, who's been relatively quiet since the first. And here the Aggies force a turnover. Sussman got her hands in there. Sable down the floor. A dime sets up Sussman. Beautiful pass. Transfer to transfer. And the lead is back to 13. They're looking for Lalotte, trying to get a clean entry in. They get it to her here. And there was Tess Sussman.
So I think they were listening to me because that was three players right there.
She tried to go middle, but Tess Sussman was right there. Here's another look at Tova Sable working hard. And then Sussman with a steal, and this is a beautiful pass.
Great run by Tess, too.
He's the transfer out of Harvard, Tess Sussman, as Campbell Gray tips this one out of bounds. She's working on her MBA here at UC Davis. Broncos still have some time, but they got to score, and they got to score in bunches. Lalotte, not that time. She went baseline.
Didn't go middle.
And now the Aggies run it back.
That transfer telepathy again.
Is there something in the transfer portal where you just, you learn a new language or something? I don't know.
Maybe, I don't know. I don't know. Good question.
Transfer portal, some like mythical space and time.
I mean, the word portal just makes me think like something's going on in there.
There's a foul called against UC Davis. Yeah, Sussman and Sable have been working beautifully. First Turner set up the fast break, and the ball barely hit the floor. Sussman has 10 points. I mean, she barely scored her first couple games.
They both got 10, transfer.
Gordy Presnell, I mean, he is very frustrated on the sideline with the way that Boise State's running their offense. And it turns into a missed three. Campbell Gray, time to set her feet. That's a three, count it. And the Aggies have expanded the lead to 18.
Davis is really capitalizing on Boise's mistakes. You can see there, the coach was a little frustrated not running the out of bounds play right. They score right there, but I think Davis is doing a good job of pushing the ball in transition, looking for the open shot.
Boise State is 2-for-10 from distance, and the Aggies really getting out in transition now. They have scored 14 points in the open floor. Sable to the rim with the left hand. It curls out. And see if the Broncos have one last push to make this a ball game late. Narrow. There's nobody there. And that's a backcourt violation. Miscommunication with Danny Bays. Meanwhile, Campbell Gray hits her fourth three, or I beg your pardon, her first three of the year. She hit only three last season, but a player that continues to gain more and more confidence. Another player that really had a devastating injury a couple years ago, and you can tell she's really getting her confidence back now. He's by 16. Sussman works it back to Harris, to Turner. That is a deep one. And it's a foul going the other way. Turner can't hit from out there. Has pretty unlimited range. There's foul called against Megan Norris on the rebound. And that was from well beyond the NBA line. She went over the back, did Megan Norris. It's her third. Boise State, they were picked to finish seventh in the Mountain West. They returned pretty much every player from last year's team except for their top scorer. Another foul off the ball. It's the third of the quarter against UC Davis at Sussman. I mentioned they had only won 8 games last year, but 9 of those losses were by 6 points or less. Here's another look at the foul against Sussman, a little over-aggressive. Mary Kay Narrow with a floater, and that rolls off. And they bring back all that talent, plus they have some what Gordy Presnell called their best freshman class maybe ever. There are a lot of expectations for the Broncos this year. Tip ball by Lalonde. It's still loose, and this time a foul given to Allie Heckman. Another look at the foul. Greg Wong and Kayla Livingston with you here on ESPN Plus. We'll be with you for every home game this year. The Aggies play here at University Credit Union Center. And the Aggies trying to finish out a terrific win here in non-conference. Sussman on the drive, gets to her strong hand and works it back. Extra pass, Turner, this will count. Adding to her career afternoon, 29 points. And she has hit
2 buzzer shots.
And that one her 6-3. It's a foul. It's called against Allie Heckman. I'm assuming a lot of this is because of how inspired she was being the bridesmaid of the person sitting to my left.
I think I just inspire her as a player as she, you know, hits that last one. But, I mean, Evan's always in the gym working hard, so I'm not shocked that she makes those. Always exciting.
And I think she has 6 threes right now. I believe the record for threes in a game is 8 for UC Davis. That's what Kelsey Harris hit in 2015 in the Big West Tournament. I remember that because that was my last year of college. I'm an old man.
You say 2015?
Yeah.
I graduated high school in 2017.
Okay, Kayla.
Should we talk about the year we were born?
Let's go back to the game. You're still in the 90s, all right?
99,
yeah,
barely.
That still counts. So Turner just 2 threes away from tying that record. Again, unofficially. Megan Norris has it. Turner for her 7th. No, and the rebound by Mary Kay Narrow. And the Broncos just haven't been able to get going offensively since the opening quarter. Missed 3 that time. Burns hits the floor hard. Second chance effort. They're just 2 for 11 on threes. Make it 2 for 12. And Turner with the rebound. And this is a team that a lot is expected. I think Gordy Presnell thinks that this team can be a lot better shooting the ball than they were last year, where they finished last in the Mountain West in 3-point shooting. Back door. And a foul called. Sussman got hit. And that'll take us to our last break. Aggies have opened it up to 17-point lead for UC Davis over Boise State. And Evan Turner has a career-high 29 points. And 19 career victories at Boise State for Gordy Presnell. 790 for his career in total. He has the most victories ever for a Boise State head coach. But things looking gloomy so far with 4:10 to go, and the Aggie lead is down to 14. I think the Aggie, they took a three away from UC Davis. It was 17 at the break. Turner first to hoist this one. Oh, she almost banked it in.
I don't know what I would have done if that went in, to be honest.
And that was close. Meanwhile, Muse the other end. So they did take a three away from the Aggies. That was miscounted. And so it's a 14-point lead instead. Turner sitting on career high 29. But Boise State, they're going to probably have to start hitting some threes. They've only hit two. Both of those were in the first quarter. Narrow, no good. Rebound saved by Muse. Narrow gets to it, and she got hemmed in and fouled by Burns. And this is going to get them to the line. And this is a nice hustle from Boise State to keep this possession alive. Look at Abby Muse fight with Megan Norris.
Yeah, Boise State, their shots aren't falling, but they're definitely still hustling, trying to get those second chance shots, which is good to see. But I think what they need to do is just, you know, try to get it in as much as they can. Their top scorer isn't scoring that much. She just goes out, but the other girls are able to contribute as well.
Yeah, Muse just 1 for 3, and she really hasn't been able to get into the rhythm of the game because of the early fouls. She missed all but 1 minute of the first half because she picked up 2 fouls in the first minute of the game. Free throws up and in for Mary Kay Narrow. Player that has had a lot of success in Boise from Beaverton, Oregon, where she played for her mom, Kathy. So 3 minutes left. Aggie's still in a good spot. A few more buckets should put this game on ice. Turner. Step back. Four to shoot. Sussman trying to lay it up. That did not hit iron. And so it is a violation. So the Aggies, the last two possessions, have not gotten a good shot up. They've had to hoist one with the shot clock winding down. Here's Hansen. Lavrovic with the left. And that was a clean look, just missed it. And Turner brings it down. Aggies with 14 points in transition. Probably you could add more to that they got that weren't officially in the open floor. Norris with a hook shot, short. And the rebound tipped into the hands of Maya Hansen. You can tell that the half court set still works in progress, as you might expect. Another foul. These are tough ones for UC Davis. Turner is called for the foul. Jen Gross not happy. Disagreed with that foul call. Again, this will get the Aggies to the line. What'd you think, Kayla?
I think Evan was still trying to establish her position, so I can see how that was a foul.
Yeah, not in legal guarding position. And so get them to the line. And for a team that's struggling to put the ball in the hoop, they'll certainly take these free chances. Trista Hull, the sophomore from Yakima, Washington, makes it a 10-point game. The Yankees are going to have to sweat this one out for the final 2:08. And again, because of these free throws, the Aggies have not been able to get out in the open floor. Boise State is 22 for 23 from the line today. And this time a foul going against Boise. A little tangled feet. Mozzie Harris and Trista Hull. That one surprised you, Kayla.
I just saw everyone on the ground. Yep. I didn't know what was going on.
It's the third team foul, but it does reset the shot clock to 20, so the Aggies at minimum can burn some more clock. All right, Kayla, what'd you think of this? Ooh, now I said it too. Mozzie Harris,
well,
just kind of a collision.
Yeah,
that could have gone either way. The Aggies are content to use most of this timer. See if they can get a good look here. That ball was tipped. Turner gets to it. Three to shoot. One-footed shot. Turner can't get it. And here come the Broncos, who need points in a hurry. Mary Kay Nero up top to Lavrovich. Lavrovich, nice take to the rim. 8-point game. I think that was a little too easy for Jen Gross's liking.
Yeah, Megan needed to come over on that and help instead of staying with her player.
Boise State, they pretty much need to pitch a shutout, though, for the remainder of the game to have a chance. But the Aggies have not been able to generate good looks down the stretch. Norris rips, attacks, lays it up, doesn't get it, and Nero the rebound. And here come the Broncos pushing it. Hansen stops, that's a two-pointer, count it, and it's a 6-point game with 44 seconds to go. And Gordy Presnell calls a timeout. I think for sure this has started defensively for Boise. The Aggies have not been able to expand this lead, and meanwhile, the Broncos have scored 10 unanswered points.
Yeah, I mean, the last few shots have gone down to 2 seconds on the shot clock, and I know they're trying to run the clock down, but when you're not going to get a good shot after the clock winds down, that can be tough, allowing Boise to get second chance or get shots on the other end. So with 44 seconds here, be smart with the shots you're taking, but on both sides, if you're going to take it, if you're not going to take it.
Yeah, Kale, I want to talk about that a little bit because the Aggies are about to have the ball. Boise State was the one that called the timeout, but you played in this offense for many years. You have a lot of experience. First of all, how did the game change down the stretch where things tend to become more half-court oriented? And for UC Davis, what are kind of the guiding principles that you can go back to when they're sputtering like they are right now that you can kind of hang your hat on and say, if we can do X, Y, and Z, then we'll be able to generate something clean?
Yeah, I think, and Jen talks about this all the time, just going back to the fundamentals. You don't have to make the crazy pass, you know, the one that zips through everyone. Just, you know, take your time, jab step, get them off of you, and make that smart pass. And I think right now, maybe it's a little like, okay, let's run down the clock, we're up, but we also need to, they also need to be smart about how far they're running down the clock or what passes that they're making, still being sharp with each and every cut.
Yeah, there's a 14-second differential between the shot and game clock. I'd expect Boise to foul here. Would you? Yeah?
Yeah, foul, try to get, or not foul, kind of go for a quick
steal.
Yeah, go
for a steal, yeah.
I mean, there's been steals on each side, but ultimately a foul to not let the clock run down.
Yep. But they're a good pressing team. Again, they forced 22 turnovers against Weber State in the last game. We've seen it today. And the Aggies actually have done a pretty nice job taking care of the ball since the little blip to open up the game. They've turned it over 13 times. So we'll see if the Broncos are able to get a steal. Aggies, if you're thinking free throws, Evan Turner last year, she only missed 4 the entire season.
Yeah, and they have 2 fouls to give, so.
Yep. That's a good point. 3 team fouls for Boise State. So here comes that pressure. And what's the call? I think we got a timeout. A timeout called by Jen Gross to save the possession. Otherwise, it would have been a 5-second violation. So we'll do it again. All right, Kayla. Ask you again. How do you get the ball in these situations?
Screens, fakes, not passing into the corner. As you can see, they're pressing right now. So I think now that they have 2 fouls to give, I think that they'll take both of those fouls pretty quickly and then try to go for the steal. But, yeah, you don't want to catch it in the corner and you don't want to dribble and pick it up because that's how you get stuck in the corner. And being in the backcourt, you have nowhere really to throw it. So that's what Davis needs to do, and Boise is going to bring that pressure, so they just need to be prepared.
Let's see if the Aggies here, I think they might have advanced the ball to half court as well, and it looks like they did, just to give them a little more space. So, like Kayla said, Boise's going to look for a turnover, otherwise you would think they'd have to foul with such little separation between the two clocks. Sussman will be the trigger woman. Trying to free up Sydney Burns. She's got it. And she is quickly fouled by Lavrovich, who's from Gig Harbor, Washington. And there's the foul to give. The next one will send the Aggies to the line. Aggies get it in to Megan Norris. She got fouled by Lalotte. So Norris going to the line. I think for Boise, I think that's probably one of the players that they want to see at the stripe. Norris this year, though, there's not a lot of data on how good she is at the line. She's 4-for-7 so far this season in her young career. And she is a good shooter, so. One free throw would make it a three-possession game. That would be significant. And so there's going to be a lot of pressure on this one. Got it. That's huge. 7-point game with 42 seconds to go. And so Boise State will use a timeout. Are you thinking, well, there's still 42 seconds to go. Broncos' best available shot still at this point. Do you think they're going to try to generate a three?
I think it could go either way. I would say generate a three. But you never know. I mean, 42 seconds, that's kind of
still a lot of time to play the foul game, yeah.
Unfortunately, it's still a lot of time because you wouldn't think 42 seconds is a lot. But in basketball time, oh, that's like 10 minutes. That could be 10 minutes.
I'm going to start timing it now, Kayla.
Yeah.
If not, then you're in big trouble. Yeah, 42 seconds, that really is an eternity in college basketball. But if the Aggies force a stop, then that would really put Boise in a hole. Pasco. And she stepped out of bounds. And that might do it.
Well, they were generating the three, so yep. We were right in some point.
To their best three-point shooter, but Hill went out of bounds on the sideline.
That's always unfortunate, too. It's never fun stepping out of bounds. I mean, barely,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, that left foot just stepped out. And so Mozzie Harris is at the line. Pasco has had just a remarkable start to her career. Again, coming back home to Northern California today, the only road game of non-conference for Boise. Harris hits both, and that should just about do it. It's a 9-point game with 35 seconds to go. And this would be a pretty impressive win for the Aggies against a good Mountain West team. Hansen feeds Lalotte, can't get it there. Offensive rebound Muse to Pasco, and now they're definitely looking for a three. Narrow instead will take it inside, can't hit. That's out of bounds. It'll stay with Boise, but a lot of time came off the clock. 18 seconds to go. Hansen to trigger. Narrow gets loose inside, and Turner commits a foul. Could be wrong, but I don't think she agreed. And I'll send Narrow to the line with 17 seconds to go. Kayla, I mean, you've been friends with Evan a long time. I don't think she agreed with that, if I can tell correctly. Correct me if I'm wrong.
No, I think you're correct.
Yeah.
I know. You know, you never agree with anything the ref says, so I
That's
can
true.
Understand that.
The first foul that I've seen a player agree with will be the first ever. Narrow hits both. Jen Gross will use the timeout. 17 seconds to go, and the Aggies lead 69-62.
How many minutes are we at?
I think we're about two or three. I'll be honest, Kayla, I didn't actually keep track. I'm sorry. I lied to you.
Because I do count the timeouts with it.
Well, this timeout does give us a chance to for me to say welcome, Kayla. Very excited to have you on the broadcast. I know everybody in our audience is smiling ear to ear when they hear your voice after watching you for four seasons here at UC Davis on the floor. You also had a redshirt year. And why don't you let the listeners in on what you're up to these days. You have some time to call games, obviously, but you're still in the area.
I am.
What you got cooking?
Gonna be going to school starting January 3rd, occupational therapy. But, you know, this is my home, so I will be here. That's why I only moved 20 minutes away. The sole reason so I could do this with you.
University of Pacific, too.
Yes.
In Sacramento.
Yes, in Sacramento.
And I am flattered. Thank you, Kayla.
Just for you.
Boise State won't foul. And that'll do it. Aggies with their second win of the season, and they defeat a perennial Mountain West Conference powerhouse, Boise State, who has reloaded this year with some outstanding freshman talent. But today it's the Aggies that win by 7. Evan Turner with 26 points. So they did take a 3 away from Evan Turner. That was the 3 that was taken off the scoreboard. But it's still a career high, 26 for Evan, 8 for 21 shooting. And the Aggies hold on at the end to beat Boise State 69-62. Kayla, I'll send it to you for the final thoughts. What were your overall impressions from the game, coming off a tough loss against Washington for UC Davis? Great to come back home and get a win against a tough mid-major.
Yeah, I think Davis came back and from that loss, and they took what they learned in the last game and brought it here, and they fixed that. And I think the rebounding was a big thing, and I think everyone was just more confident this game as well. You could see it in their shooting and the way that they were playing, and they were having fun out there. I mean, you can see them smiling, and I always like when people smile. So I think that was a good win for them, a good confidence booster. So the next game should be good as well.
Nice job, Kayla.
Thank you very much, Greg.
Welcome aboard, and we look forward to having you the rest of the year. Aggies, after this, go to the Golden One Center Tuesday for the Causeway Classic against Sac State. That'll be the next game for UC Davis. Here, it's a win. The Aggies with their second win of the year. They defeat Boise State 69-62. For our producer, Sam Wadalevich, and Kayla Livingston, I'm Greg Wong. We'll see you next time here on ESPN+.